So, as per your syllabus, let me see, like which one is left now. Just give me some time. So I'm checking your syllabus.
हेलो, सागर बात कर रहे हैं। अच्छा, मैं एक उनका नंबर लगा रहा था, उन्होंने इंगेज कर दिए थे उस पे। वो है, मैं फर्स्ट लग नहीं रहा सर, वो 7 से जो स्टार्ट हो रहा है ना, मैं तो क्लास इंचार्ज बोल रहा हूँ। शर्मा उनको एक बार बोल दूँ, मुझे भी कॉन्टैक्ट कर लें।
So, how many of you have written, the topic I told you guys to write down? So, how many of you have written? Students, am I audible to you? Students, are you listening to me? Am I audible? Okay, today we'll do practice on table graph. So we have done bar graph, line graph, and pie charts. Now today we'll do practice on table graph. So I'll show you one of the question. As I told you, like, questions it can be asked in a different ways, but we should know that the answer it will remain same because the motive of writing the report is they want to know that if the information is provided to you, how would you elaborate that or how would you define it in a simpler language? Okay, so I have shared the screen with you. You can see the format of a table graph. That how a table graph it could come to you. Look, the table below shows information and prediction regarding the change in percentage of the population age 65 and above in 3 countries. So on this side, they have given the name of the countries like Canada, Germany, UK. And on this side, they have given the years like 1988, 2000, 2030. So in 1988, in Canada, the population at the age of 65 was 16.32%. And in 2000, it was 20.67%, and 2030, it was 26.35%. So it has risen, we can say, like that in Canada. So that is what you call a table graph, because a table, it is drawn in front of you. It could be of other type, but just for example, we have taken this. Now, how it is written, the table gives information like in the previous graphs. If you remember, we have written names of the charts or the graphs. We wrote like pie chart is depicting information. We have written table graph. We have written line graph is telling us the information about our bar graph is drawn. So now table graph is drawn. So that's why they are writing. The table gives information about the proportion of the population who are 65 years old and over in 3 countries, Canada, Germany, and UK in 1988, 2000, and an estimated percentage in 2030. So that is basically the percentage as I was telling you. So in the next paragraph, they have started comparing the data. Overall, the population of elderly people is predicted to rise in all 3 countries from 1988 to 2030. The highest percentage of older people was in Germany, which will continue to remain the highest in 2030, while the lowest proportion can be seen in the UK over the period given. So in the main body paragraph, they have started comparing it. They have said that overall the population of elderly people is predicted to rise in all 3 countries. So when we have seen that there is no country where the age of 65 people, the percentage of these age group has reduced. Okay, so that's why they wrote this line. The highest percentage of older people was in Germany. So now they told which country was having the highest population of age group of 65 amongst the other countries. Then they compare it with the other country like UK. Between 1988 and 2000, the aging population of Canada and Germany went up by around 5% to 20.67 and 25.32 respectively. As I was trying to tell you about Canada, you know, so they have also compared by writing two of the years, 88 and 2000, and population of Canada and Germany went up by 5 to 20.67 and 25 respectively. So we can see in the chart, they have said that between 1988 to 2000, in they are taking the example of Germany and Canada. So Canada is, they are saying, around 5 to 20.67 and 25 respectively. So they took calculation out of it. For example, you know, 88, Canada's population of 65 years old was 16.32 to 2000. They have said that is 20. So it's almost like 5%, we can say this thing. And to 20.67 and 25 respectively. So this is what they are talking about, like from here. Here it is like, you know, 5%. That is how they calculated it, and they have said that the difference is 5%. So data is this 20.67 and 25.32. So which is written over here, 20.67, 25.32, and percentage is around 5%. The UK, on the other hand, showed relatively little change in the proportion of its population age 65 plus and remained at just under 15% in both years. Okay. By 2030, it is expected that the population of people age 65 and above will increase by approximately 5.5% in all three countries. By 2030, it is expected that population. Now, why it is written here? I don't understand. 2030, where we are right now, 2020. So here we are predicting what we are doing. We can talk about 1988 to 2000, but we cannot talk about 2030. So that is what we are expecting. That's why they changed their tense. So they wrote will, look. So they changed their tense from past to future. A lot of times students, they ask like in which tense we should write down. You know, I have seen some of the videos where, you know, people are suggesting that you should write down report and always in past tense. That is not possible. You're supposed to see the situation. Sometimes there are chances they could ask you something from the future. So by 2030, it is expected. So they used word expected. They have not written like it is going to happen. They said that it is expected that the population of people aged 65 and above will increase by approximately 5.5% in all three countries. Because they have seen growth from 1988 to 2000, it is approximately 5%. So they are expecting the same kind of percentage in upcoming years as well. That's why they wrote like approximately 5.5% in all three countries. The percentage is forecast to reach 30.42 in Germany, 26.35 in Canada, and 20.35 in the UK. Again, I tell you this thing, whether it is written 5.5 and they took it, the example from, you know, the previous years, but we cannot assume anything from ourselves. Whether we have written this expected that population would be this much, but we are not expecting from our own mind. Try to see. The information is already given to us and they wrote already that it is a year of 2030, which you need to imagine. So for even imagination, it has been, you know, directed to us that we should, follow the data which is given to us. So what we're supposed to do, we're supposed to only follow that data which is given to us. And we cannot just write down something from our mind. Like if it is 2030, we would start writing something different from here. Like, you know, you could say that, you know, I expect that in Canada, you know, it will reach up to 30%. No, we cannot, because data is given to us. It is provided to us. So we cannot change that data. So that is how it is written. So this is what you call another way of writing the report with a different format. As I told you, pie chart, line graph, bar graph, table graph. Graph would be different, means the information it could be provided to in a different way. But you're supposed to see, we can see there are some other information, you know, but answer it will remain the same. Look, there is a question over here. If you're seeing, they're saying table below shows the proportion of income spent on four common items in UK 1998. So that is again a table graph where they have provided the information. A table below shows the proportion of income spent on four common items in UK. The proportion of income adults and children spent on four common items in UK in 1998. So food, electronic equipment, music and videos, these are four items. And they have divided the categories, adults, men, women, children, boys, girls. So these are different categories they have divided. Then they have given the percentage of different these categories, like by food, by electronic, by music, by videos. Now the answer is not given, you know, written over here. So what we could do, we can write down by seeing this thing. So there should be one first paragraph. If we take the example from this, you know, we can write down table graph gives information about what? About the proportion of income adults and children spent on four common items in the UK in 1998. This is what they have said that. Okay. And we can add this, word. and data is given in an estimated percentage. So that will be your first paragraph. So in the second paragraph, you would start comparing these things. So in the second paragraph, you can write down, there are four items which are provided in the table graph. And if we take the example of, you know, adults and men, okay, we can take, because there are six categories, so we can write three paragraphs by choosing two, two, and two. So you can choose here, if we take example of adults and men, percentage of adults on the basis of food was higher as compared to men, but percentage of electronic equipment was lesser as compared to men, and but at the music and videos, they were almost at the same level. So percentage was almost same, so they were at the same level, because 5, 5, 1, 2. So this is how we took the example of two things over here. So in this next paragraph, we can write about, in the second, in the next paragraph, we can discuss like, then they have discussed about women and children. Percentage difference is very high as compared to food, because women, you know, the proportion of the income of women is about 39% as compared to children, it is only 10%. But it is opposite as compared to electronic equipment, because women's proportion is 1% and children's proportion is 23%. The same condition it is into the example of music, where there is a percentage of 5 and 39%. And similarly, videos, 0.5 to 12%. So this is how we have compared in second paragraph, women and children. In the third paragraph, then we can talk about, when we take the example of boys and girls. So in case of food, they are about almost at the similar level. 9 and 11% is not very big difference. But electronic equipment, there is difference. Boys has given the boys have given the proportion of 18% as compared to the girls, which is just at 5%. Again, at the music and videos, both are at the same level, 38 up to 40% and 18 and 17%. So we can see that music and videos, there is no bigger change between the boys and girls. So we wrote three paragraphs and we described these, you know, six categories into it. As I've told you that in those kind of report writing, we should not add anything from our own, because it has not asked from us that write down any recommendation or how did you get that data. Data is provided to us into form of a question. Our duty was only to write that information in form of words. The tabular information is given to us. Mathematical, statistical information is given to us. We're supposed to change it into a form of written language. So this is what we have done. So that is how we can write down our report. Okay, first was introductory paragraph, then we made three paragraphs for explaining these six categories and four categories of these six. Okay, so now tell me if you have got any of the question. We have just solved online one of the report writing. Is it clear to everybody now?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, इसको इस तरीके से हम ले, लेकिन सिर्फ काम इतना है कि आपको थोड़ा सा टाइम स्पेंड करना पड़ेगा ऑन क्वेश्चन. अगर हम एकदम से इसके ऊपर जंप करेंगे तो विल बी हार्ड फॉर यू, ये आपके लिए मुश्किल हो सकता है कि हाँ जी एक क्वेश्चन है, इसको अब किस तरह से हम सॉल्व करें. मैंने आपको बोला है कि आपको पहले तो फॉर्मेट नहीं छोड़ना है. इफ यू विल फॉलो द फॉर्मेट, इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू टू सॉल्व इट. फॉर्मेट मींस द फर्स्ट पैराग्राफ, it's a dead rule, you're supposed to write down about the introduction. In introduction, you will just write down what kind of a graph it is, what information it has been provided in the graph or chart. That is your introduction. Then it comes your explanation part. So you write down observations. So what did you observe? So, you know, the table graph is given to us. So try to see how the information has been presented to you. So there are four items and six categories they have divided, and there is a percentage. So the items are four and the categories are six. So it means if you will go one by one, it will be a very lengthy paragraph. So we do not want to write too much lengthy. So what can we do? We can club it. So 6 by 2 means we will write down 3 paragraphs. One paragraph, 2 items we will take and we will try to compare it. And this is paper of your English. Do not write like, you know, as it is written, adult is 3%, man is 4% on food. Then adult is 6% and man is 2% on electronic equipment. Means don't try to just write like that. Try to use your mind, because more you write the lines, you will get more marks. Because this is your paper of English, so they want to see that how can you compare it. So that's why I've said that, you know, you can write down like, you know, there is less change, there is more change, there is no change. Kind of these lines you should use it. So you can tell them, you know, I am comparing what I'm seeing, the percentage, what I'm seeing of food and electronic items. This is the difference. Or in the last category, as we have just discussed, like, you know, among boys and girls, there is very less change of proportion in case of videos. So you just write down that line. You need not to write down that percentage is 15% or 16% and percentage is 17%. Rather to write down 15 and 17%, you can just write down there is very less change of, you know, percentage or proportion, whatever it is given to you. So use more of words, less of mathematical information. That is what it is. Okay. इसको प्लीज साथ में लिख के जरूर देखिएगा, क्योंकि आप लोगों को जो पेपर है, एग्जाम है फाइनल, उसमें आप लोगों की जो मार्क्स हैं, दैट इज गोइंग टू कम टू यू फॉर 15 मार्क्स. ये चीज जो रिपोर्ट राइटिंग आपको होने वाली है, जो अभी तक फाइनल्स में आती है, वो यूजुअली आपको